Hi everyone, I am Arvind, working as a lecturer in Shraddha College and executive member in Nalgonda Economics Forum. Welcome to Nalgonda Economics Forum. In this video, we'll try to understand absolute advantage theory, right? So, in this world, generally every country will not going to self-sufficient, right? So, they may be produce some particular commodities, some countries will produce some other commodities, right? So, here, every country will not going to satisfy each and every commodity. So in this case, we'll try to depend on imports rest of the world countries. So as like that, Adam Smith, so according to absolute advantage theory in 1776, Adam Smith in his book, he explained the wealth of nations clearly about the absolute advantage theory. So what the absolute advantage theory means that. So here, Adam Smith stated that international trade is beneficial only when the two nations have absolute differences in the cost of production, the commodity in which they specialize, right? So here, every country that they will try to produce different commodities. So in this case, Adam Smith stated that the country, whichever, by using whatever the cost of production, it should be high, the production. The production should be high, the absolutely, it should be very high. The production, whatever the commodity is going to produce, higher amount, right? That is the product which can be exported, right? Whatever the commodity, which is a very less amount of production, which is being done by that particular commodity, which is scarce commodity, that can be imported from the rest of the world countries, right? That is the essence of absolute advantage cost theory, right? So once again, we'll try to understand here. Adam Smith stated that international trade is beneficial only when the two nations have absolute differences, right? Two nations should have absolute differences in the cost of production. In the cost of production should be completely different. So here the cost of production is same, the whatever the commodity should be same. In this case, we are not going to do trade, right? There should be differences, whatever the cost of production, whatever the commodity, whatever the taste and variety, should be different. Then only we'll try to do exports and import, right? So in this case, absolute differences in the cost of production of the commodity in which they specialize. So here we'll try to understand further the best example, whatever India and China, right? So before going to the crux of this particular advantage theory, whatever the absolute advantage theory, we'll try to understand assumption. What are the main assumptions of absolute advantage theory? So here we can go through these particular assumptions. Complete specialization, right? The country should be have specialized, right? Particular country A or particular country B, there should be specialized particular commodity, right? And coming to absolute advantage theory, there is a one more assumption, 2 into 2 into 1 model, right? Here, two nations, two commodities, and one labor factor. Two nations, two commodities, one labor factor. And coming to the third important assumption is that perfect competition. So, while doing this particular trade, two countries, two commodities, one labor factor, they should follow the perfect competition. I am coming to full employment. A country should have full employment. I am coming to free trade. Free trade means that countries, while doing trade, one country to another country. So in that case, there should not any tariffs and any excise duties, right? There should be any restrictions while doing trade. That is what free trade and perfect mobility of factor within the nation but not outside the nations, right? So here, perfect mobility means what are the labor factor? Labor, there should be mobility wherever they can move from that particular within the country but not rest of the world country, but not outside the nation, they should not mobilize, right? That is what 6 more important assumptions in this absolute advantage theory. By following these assumptions, we will try to understand the best example here. Country like China, India, right? These two nations and two commodities, wheat and paddy, right? 2 into 2 into 1 model, right? Here, two nations, China and India, and commodities, wheat and paddy. These two commodities, right? So here, one labor factor, by using single labor factor, which can be produced, which can produce and which can do the trade by two countries, right? So here, we can understand here by following this table, here, China will produce 210 units of wheat and China will produce 110 units of paddy, right? And here, coming to India, India will produce 80 units of wheat and paddy, 200 units of paddy India will going to produce. So this is the example for this particular absolute advantage theory. So what is essence of this particular table? We'll try to understand. See here, China will produce 210 units of wheat and paddy it's only 110, right? So here China is specialized to produce wheat. Here 210 units of wheat which is produced by the China. I'm coming to India. India will produce wheat only 80 units. Okay, coming to China, 210 units China will going to produce with the same whatever the cost of production labor by using the labor. Right, and coming to India, India will produce only 80 units of wheat and coming to paddy, 200 units of paddy. So this is what India to produce specialization in the production of paddy and China which is specialized to produce whatever wheat, right? China specialized to produce wheat and India specialized to produce what? Paddy, right? This is what specialization. China is specialized to produce the wheat and India specialized to produce wheat. That is the word. That is what here, complete specialization. So China specialized to produce wheat and India specialized to produce whatever paddy, right? This is what first assumption we clear, right? So here in this case we, these particular countries like China and India, Adam Smith said that based on this is what absolute advantage theory, by using this whatever the labor factor, whichever specialized, which they specialize. So China specialized 210 units of wheat and India specialized 200 units of paddy. So in this case they will both try to do trade. So then both countries can be developed, right? So according to Adam Smith, earlier the mercantilism believed that only export can do, imports are restrictions. So here in absolute advantage theory, both country can be developed by doing exports and import. Whatever the country, they are specialized in their particular commodity, so they can do export and whatever the scale, they will try to import. That is what is essence of this particular absolute advantage theory. So coming to mercantilism theory, there is a only whatever exports can be done, whatever the European countries, richer countries can become a richer and remaining whatever the lower developed country, they are not going to develop. So in this case, it is not like that. Every country can do free trade. There is a free trade option here. Free trade, there is no restrictions and there is no custom duty side on. So countries can do trade based on their specialized. For example, India is specialized to produce paddy and China is specialized to produce whatever wheat. So this is what is in some absolute advantage theory. So here China will try to, China try to export wheat 210 units to India and India will going to export 200 units of paddy to the China. That is what in this case, both countries can going to develop. They are going to develop, right? That is the essence of this particular absolute advantage theory. Hope you understand. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe.